Before you harvest honey for the first time, keep in mind some beekeepers choose to do so in the fall, while some wait until spring. By waiting until spring, you leave your bees with full honey stores, giving them the best chance of survival through the winter by way of maximum food supply. Check with local beekeepers if you're unsure of how much honey to leave your bees for winter. You'll want to be cautious with how much you harvest, since a colony's sole purpose is to create enough food stores for their health and success through winter and into spring. It's always better to leave them more than to take too much and put the colony at risk. We recommend leaving all honey on most first-year hives so that they can become established and have the best chance of survival through the coldest months. When harvesting honey, accept that it will be messy. Doing it in a garage or a place away from nosy, foraging bees will make your life easier. Regardless of how you plan to gather honey, tools you will want for taking boxes or bars and cutting the comb are your hive tool, possibly your smoker, and a brush. A swarm bag can be helpful as well. If you're harvesting multiple boxes, it's nice to have a place to set one and cover it so the bees attracted to the free food can't land to gather on the box or the bars you just cleaned out. Bee escapeboards are a great way to clear bees out of surplus honey boxes on both Langstroth and Worry hives. Foundationless hives can be harvested two ways, by cutting off and then crushing and straining the comb, or by making cut comb honey. A strainer is an easy way to let gravity and heat do the work. Cutting combs into the top bucket and then crushing it up and letting it drain into the bottom, the effort for keeper is minimal. You'll want to crush and stir the comb in the bucket a few times to get all the honey possible. Cut comb honey is highly sought after and it's hard to find. Not only is it beautiful, but it's delicious and utilizes the entire comb as the bees intended. A simple, handled comb cutter is all that is needed. A honeycomb crush and strain system is a heavy tool that crushes the combs and leaves the wax behind. It can then be simply hosed off after use and dried in the sun.